Okay, so good afternoon, everyone, and thank you all for being patient and welcome for joining this session. A quick intro about us. We are Together Fund, India's first operator-led fund for early-stage global SaaS products. And you'll hear from me and my partner. I'm Girish Mathrubootham, founder and CEO of Freshworks. You'll hear from Manav, my partner, and there are also Shubham and the rest of the Together team is on the call in case you want to reach them by they're available via chat. Now let's get started. So Gen AI is definitely the talk of the town, and I'm sure there is no dearth of events or news articles that are bombarding all of us yesterday. So, and I'm sure most of you are like probably well-read and up-to-date and well-informed on the topic. Our focus for today's session is primarily going to be in the context of, hey, how can we help SaaS founders, both current founders who are running SaaS companies, as well as new founders who are thinking about building something in SaaS, how should they have a framework to think about how to build SaaS products for the future in an AI-first world, in the world of Gen AI? So that is going to be the focus. But before we do all of that, let's start by listening to some nice music. Okay, so now how many of you know this song? And I'm just wanted to share that this song was released in 1992. It was A.R. Rahman's first movie, Roja, and I was in first year of college. We were waiting eagerly for the audio cassette to come from our friends in Chennai who were bringing it to the hostel, and we were all in the room actually listening to this music. But in case you're wondering, why am I talking about an old song in a session about Gen AI? So I want to use an analogy of how technology evolution actually disrupts gadgets. And I want to use music as an example. Now, some of you may be very young here who have not seen, people who are born after 2000, maybe you don't even know how cassettes used to look like. But if you are from my generation, we were born in the cassette time frame, like audio tapes. And then we moved on to CDs and DVDs, which we used Walkman to hear to the listen to music. And then we all know about how MP3 players and more specifically the iPod revolutionized the music industry. And now we are listening to music on smartphones. Now, while we have lived through all these gadgets, what is fascinating is we still hold on to the music. I still listen to Roja whenever like I feel like listening to some good music, right from the days of buying the Roja audio cassette to listening to it on CD and DVD, and now on Spotify. And I'm sure all of you have your favorite music from, say, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years ago, right? Now, this is very, very important for us to understand. Now, while the gadgets can be disrupted, customers hold on to the music. And that is the framework that I'm going to use today to help all of us founders understand, hey, as we move through a Gen AI world where it's fundamentally a big disruption, how do we understand, hey, what's the gadget and what's the music in a business context, in a business world? And how can we use that framework to really think about building products for the future? And I'm going to use some examples from customer service domain, because that's the domain I know the best. But I think it's also simple enough that all of us can relate to it. But what I want you to be thinking is, once you understand this analogy of gadgets and music, how to apply it in your own company, in your own domain, on what is the music and what is the gadget? Now, I'll take a few examples. Now, this is an old example. We all know call centers. You have called Airtel, or you've called Tata Sky, you've called your credit card company. So in call centers, businesses always want to automate customer care, right? Because they can't just keep hiring more and more people. the old gadget that was invented was, hey, let's introduce an IVR where we can try some basic automation for frequent use cases. Why do customers call? Like if you're calling your credit card company, you want to know what is the current balance or you want to make a payment. So can I say press 1 to know your balance, press 2 to make a payment, or press 9 to talk to a human agent? So that is the old gadget. So what does Gen AI bring to the world? We all saw ChatGPT and we've seen so much more. So how does the future of this look like? And we are already seeing all the call center players now saying, hey, Gen AI has brought in the ability for computers or bots to actually have understand conversations and have a natural language capability. So you should expect all call center software to actually have interactive voice assistants where if you're calling a company, you don't no longer have to press the IVR. Somebody can talk to you, a bot can talk to you in full natural language, in multiple languages in the future, where you can get your issue resolved. Now, the same thing, what happened in the call center? We know that when customers started coming on chat channels, like say website chat or WhatsApp or Instagram Messenger or Apple Business Chat in the US. So the industry started adopting bots. The music was, hey, I cannot hire more and more people. I need to automate like the easy support or what we call as level one support. So how do you actually, we used to have structured bots or proprietary NLP. Today, full natural language processing is available to everybody thanks to OpenAI and ChatGPT, and we can expect more to come. So what can we expect as the new gadget, like conversational bots with full natural language capability? Now, I'm just using a few more, like in marketing, let's think about it, right? So every business wants to build a pipeline of qualified leads. So what do? The old gadget that we have is we spend marketing dollars, try to drive traffic to the website. We do A/B testing of landing pages and sign-up forms. Now, maybe that can be completely disrupted. I will tell you one, my favorite example is our portfolio company WorkHack, which is actually helping businesses, consumer businesses like travel companies and healthcare companies, generate qualified leads. It's a Gen AI company. They don't even have a website themselves where we are asking them to build one. But what they do is they are able to deploy conversational bots on WhatsApp, for example, which will talk to you about when did you last travel, post-COVID, have you started going to places that you'd like to go, where would you like to go in the next 3 months if budget were no issue, try to identify your travel needs, et cetera, and then give it as a qualified lead to a travel company like, say, Make My Trip, for example. So that is an example of how everything is up for disruption. Old gadgets can be disrupted by new gadgets once you understand what is the new capability and power that this Gen AI is putting in our hands. I can keep going on, but I think these are self-explanatory, like canned responses. In Gmail, you have canned responses. In a help desk system like Freshdesk, you have canned responses where the music was, hey, when I say music, by the way, I'm talking about the business value was, hey, I want to provide fast, consistent answers to my customers. Now, who needs canned responses? We should be disrupting that because today with OpenAI, we should be able to deliver personalized, well-drafted emails on demand, right? And we already do that. So I think this is just a framework for us to think about our existing entire world of SaaS products, all the artifacts, all the workflows that we do. What is the music and what is the gadget? And is it time for us to disrupt our gadgets? So I'm presenting that as the framework for you to think, and I hope you will like it. And when we are thinking about our roadmap, like I think as SaaS companies, I want to present three swim lanes, which are current, which we should be doing now. And this is what we do at Freshworks. So how do you think about your roadmap across three swim lanes? And the first swim lane, which we already know, is, hey, there is a fundamental change in content creation and content use cases. So we are already in the automated content era. So how can we identify all the features in our product where there is content creation involved? Can we really help our users generate automatic content? Whether it's answers via chatbots or it's drafting blog posts, it's creating marketing campaigns, generating images and so on. So we all know Jasper or Midjourney or Firefly, but what I was fascinated by, I don't know how many of you have seen it, I'll put it on the chat if you have seen, Yesterday, I got something on WhatsApp, which is a Malu version of Godfather with Mohanlal and Mammootty and Fahad Fasil. It's completely generated by deep AI. It's fake, but it's awesome. Like if you, it's on YouTube. You can actually check it out after the session for Godfather Malu version or whatever and deep AI. So this is something which was created by AI. It's mind-blowing. So we are already in the content era. Now, as a SaaS founder, if you have not thought about and incorporated automatic content generation use cases across your entire product, you better start doing it now and get it done in a few weeks. Now, the second swim lane is what I call as the co-pilot era. So how do we augment human capability with generative AI? Now, we have already started seeing co-pilots. Like we all know the GitHub co-pilot, which helps you write code in Freshworks. We have launched our own co-pilots, which I'll talk to you about in a short while. There are co-pilots for research writing. There are co-pilots for sales. There are co-pilots for VC investing also, right? And somebody's going to build it. So we should expect a world where there is a lot of co-pilots, which is helping humans get more productive. And whether it's getting answers or next best action, but the most important change with co-pilot is going to be in the context of SaaS products. We are going to move from a UI-driven world to a conversational prompt-driven world, which means anything that today your users have to click through UI to do it, whether it's setting up a meeting in CRM or adding a follow-up task in support or adding a new agent as an admin, creating a new bot workflow, creating a marketing campaign, all of the tasks that users were going to do by clicking on UI are now automatable to be delivered and done in a conversational prompt. And this is actually a low hanging fruit because you can turn conversational prompts into JSON queries pretty easily. And those JSON queries can be used to hit your APIs. So I think this is something that we are going to see across all SaaS products. So this is going to be like a new way of working, a fundamental change in the way we as humans work with software. And it's going to be exciting. So the next, the third swim lane is about, hey, how do we see a fundamental change in data-driven decision-making as we know it today? So leaders and managers, today, if you look at what is happening in most SaaS software, the data actually is unstructured when it comes in. Like it can come in from emails, it can come in from website form fills, it can come in from chats, phone calls, social media posts. All of this data is unstructured. And we have been using human beings mostly to structure this data, whether we ask them to fill lead properties or ticket properties. So we are structuring the data. And recently, in the last maybe 4 or 5 years, we've been using machine learning to automatically structure the data by learning how humans do it. But why did we do that? We did all of that because only structured data is queryable. We put all of that and have these data analysts create dashboards and reports and charts and widgets so that we can understand the data in a more meaningful way. And then leaders and managers sit at the end of the quarter and look at these charts and reports and dashboards and figure out, hey, what's happening in the last quarter, and how can I take some actionable insights by understanding this data? And a lot of this is best practices that are currently available today. Like in customer service, you're measuring NPS scores or CSAT. In sales, you're looking at targets and pipeline and seeing if you're going to hit the target or not. In marketing, you track conversion rates and you know the historical data and you're trying to see how can I get better conversion and so on. We are going to see all of this fundamentally getting disrupted with the ability where Gen AI is bringing you the ability to understand unstructured data. So a lot of the current best practices, current decision making with data-driven decision making can be delivered in real time, can be delivered automatically without having to wait for this whole data conversion process. And that will throw a lot of opportunity, not just for existing SaaS players, but also for new dev tools companies working on, let's say, the modern data stack. So these are the three broad pillars. By no means it's extensive, but I think from a current SaaS product standpoint or somebody who's looking to build, I think this is a useful framework. And we use it at Freshworks. If you can go to the next slide, like we just launched our Freddy AI roadmap last week. And as you can see, we followed these three swim lanes. So Freddy self-service is for customers and employees, where it's all about the content use cases where we can really help businesses deliver personalized automation to customer answers at scale. Freddy Copilot, again, we are doing it for customer service, for sales, for marketing, for IT, for developers, for building apps on the Freddy Apps Marketplace. But think of it as, hey, how can I use Gen AI to make the life of my users more productive? How can they move on to other productive, higher order work than doing this mundane work? Like, for example, developers creating documentation in for their code. Now, Freddy Copilot can do it. And then the third one is along the data angle, where can your AI crunch current data, understand what best practices leaders are looking for, and automatically drive that, cutting down the time needed for data analysts to go and crunch the data? And also, more importantly, can you start crunching unstructured data and deliver insights, derive insights from that without having to wait for structuring? So I'm not saying structured data will go away, but now we have the capability to understand and interpret unstructured data. So how that is going to help. So purely from a SaaS founder's thinking about, hey, what should I be thinking about my roadmap? So I think these pillars hopefully can help guide what we want. And how do we create powerful differentiation? Like, I think in my mind, if we as SaaS players, or if you as startups, or maybe a fairly some of companies are further along the way, I think if we can find a domain-specific, an opportunity to create a domain-specific, well-trained model, I think that can become the most powerful weapon in our army. For example, in Freshservice, we have the opportunity, which is our IT management product, we have the opportunity to create a domain-specific model which can help understand all the IT events that are happening in a customer's place and help prevent downtime, help identify performance degradation. I'm just using that as an example. But if you can think about, hey, what data that you have, which you can create your own models, that could become a powerful differentiator for you.